In today's episode, I want to tell you something about Matare and our health center, Baraka. In which environment do we work and under which circumstances? Matare Valley is the heart of the Matare slum. It is named by the eponymous river that forms the valley of Matare. In Matare Valley, there live around 180,000 inhabitants. But nobody knows that exactly because, of course, there are no official numbers. The people who live here are the poorest you can find in Kenya. Most of them live below the poverty line. They live in houses which are 10 square meters big, and they live there with their whole family. They have no windows, and the and the walls are made of iron sheets. But even that houses are not owned by the inhabitants. No, they are owned by some landlords that are, of course, not living here, but somewhere else. So they have to rent the houses for $10 to $15 per month. Power they get usually illegally, but they have no water supply, and that is one of the biggest problems here. No clean water means nothing clean to drink, and no cooking, and no hygiene. So that is why there are tanks for water supply spread around the slum, often paid by NGOs or private people. So the people can go there, they get kind of clean water, but they have to bring it back to their homes by themselves. There are a lot of problems in Matare Valley, often caused by the poverty. For example, malnutrition, violence, and the lack of hygiene. So, and that are also the problems why the people then come to our health center. They have diseases like infectious diseases, of course, malaria, tuberculosis, or diarrhea, but all, how are you? But also HIV and other STIs. And of course, my field of studying was the injuries and the fractures that are often caused by the violence or the outrageous safety standards. So, but despite all of that problems, most of the people here are not less happy than in Europe. For example, and especially the children are so happy. And it's always nice to see them laugh and dance. Furthermore, you can get everything here in Matare Valley. They have little shops for food, they have hairdresser, they even have cinemas. Of course, the cinema is not really a cinema, not like at us. It is a dark room with benches and a TV. But they also have pubs, schools and kindergartens. Everything, of course, as you can see, in small shacks with iron sheets. And, of course, our health center, Baraka. So it's Tuesday, 4 p.m. after a hard day of work. Most of the patients left. And now George, the team leader of Baraka, will show us Baraka a little bit.
Yeah, welcome to Baraka. Thank you. This is our ambulance. We use it for patient referrals. And this is the main entrance.
Okay.
So we use, every patient uses this for entry, and then they go around and pass through the other gate.
Yes.
During the morning, a lot of them will wait here, both sides, and then we let them in one by one. This is a registration desk where all the patients must be registered, and then they are shown where to go next, which is a triage over there.
Yeah, in the morning it's really, really crowded here.
Yes.
But that's why we did it right now, because we don't want all the patients to be on camera, because we have, of course, normal issues, but also some kind of diseases that are not so welcome in the community.
Yes. Okay? So on average here we see about 270 patients Monday to Friday.
Okay.
Whenever there's a holiday in between, then the number tends to be higher.
Okay. So usually 270 per day. Okay.
Yes.
So we are 5 short-term doctors and 1 long-term doctor, but you also have a lot of other employees.
Yes. We currently have 78 employees.
78, okay.
And this 78 employees consists of drivers, security, receptionists, lab assistants, pharmacists, chefs, social workers, cleaners, male and female nurses, translators, and the clinical officers, which treat the chronic patients and perform minor operations. And here you can see the pharmacy, which looks kind of empty for European standards, but for Africa it is well equipped. For that, they follow the recommendation of the essential drugs list from the World Health Organization.
Okay, so here are even more doctor rooms. For example, this is my room. This is my room. It's not the nicest, but because I'm the surgeon and most of the time I'm not in that room, I'm in the dressing room. So, yeah. So usually we have me sitting here, the patient sitting here in the middle, and there is the place for the translator. Because of course I don't speak Kiswahili and most of the patients don't speak English. So we always need a translator.
Yes.
So now we're going to the emergency room,
which you can see here. Also no comparison to Europe, but exactly that is the challenge. You have to imagine this room full of patients receiving infusions or oxygen and are waiting for the transport to the hospitals. And right next to it we have the dressing room, in which I work most of the time, with doing casts or treating wounds. We even have an operating theater for smaller surgery, for example, like abscess incisions and sutures.
Then we go out this way. And here we come to the other facilities,
which is called CCC, Comprehensive Care Clinic, mainly for those living with HIV. And we start on this side.
Well, let's take a walk there.
This is the TB room. We strategically place it near the door so that the patients don't infect others.
So the chronic TB patients, they don't go to the main entrance.
Yes.
They come here too.
And anybody who has been identified to be coughing too much.
Yes.
Would also be brought to this side.
Also comes here. Yes. And now we are continuing to the HIV facility, right?
Yes. The left now is the waiting area for the CCC patients. Remember, I said there, we see about 270 patients per day. The TB is about 45 patients per week. And here we see about 80 patients per day.
And I can say, usually when you come here, when it's not after 4 p.m., it's also usually really
very
crowded.
Full, yes, very full.
And here, so there are special programs from the government, but usually for the most of the diseases, they have to pay for that, or how does the system in Kenya works?
In Kenya, the only free services now is delivery for mothers,
yes,
and HIV care.
Okay.
HIV and care and TB care.
And TB care.
Yes.
Okay, so there are a lot of patients we treat here. We treat them for free or just a really small amount of money because they cannot afford a healthcare in a private clinic. But does Kenya have a health insurance system?
Yes, we have National Hospital Insurance Fund. And every person who wants to be a member, yeah, has to pay $5 per month.
$5 per month.
Which is out of reach for many of them.
Yeah, so we encourage everyone to get the NHIF card,
yes,
to have that, because then you can be treated,
yes,
in a public hospital. But even that $5 per month, it's too much for a lot of inhabitants here from Atara.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
There are few who struggle to have it, but the majority don't,
yes,
have.
Thanks to George again. And at the end, some unfiltered impressions of Matara Valley.
hakuna matata. Ngeti jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani? Nzuri sana, wageni wakaribishwa. Kenya yetu, hakuna matata. Hakuna matata, ni jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani, nzuri sana, wageni, wakaribishwa, Kenya yetu, hakuna matata, ni jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani, nzuri sana, wageni, wakaribishwa. Hakuna matata, ai, jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani, nzuri sana, wageni, mwakaribishwa, Kenya yetu, hakuna matata, ngiti jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani, nzuri sana, wageni, mwakaribishwa, Kenya yetu.
How are you?
That's
not me too.
Matata, ay.